Sexpot by Charles Bukowski. You know, she said, you were at the bar so you didn't see, but I danced with this guy. We danced and we danced close, but I didn't go home with him because he knew I was with you. Thanks a bunch, I said. She was always thinking of sex. She carried it around with her like something in a paper bag. Such energy. She never forgot. She stared at every man available in morning cafes over bacon and eggs, or later over a noon sandwich or a steak dinner. I've modeled myself after Marilyn Monroe, she told me. She's always running off to some local disco to dance with a baboon, a friend once told me. I'm amazed that you've stood it for as long as you have. She'd vanish at racetracks, then come back and say, three men offered to buy me a drink, or I'd lose her in the parking lot, and I'd look up and she'd be walking along with a strange man. Well, he came from this direction and I came from that, and we kind of walked together. I didn't want to hurt his feelings. She said that I was a very jealous man. One day, she just fell down inside of her sexual organs and vanished. It was like an alarm clock dropping into the Grand Canyon. It banged and rattled and rang, but I could no longer see or hear it. I'm feeling much better now. I've taken up tap dancing, and I wear a black felt hat, pulled down low over my right eye.